Are you guys seeing me okay? This sorted out. I don't want to jinx myself, but you guys can post here. Down. Okay, great. All right, okay. And hopefully I'm here. Okay, so you guys should be seeing me now as far as I can tell. Let's see here. Seeing me? I have no idea what's going on here. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, testing. All right. Here, and I will pick up where I left off. I actually studied math at Duke University. This was years ago, graduated with a degree in math. I then went on to Harvard Law School, and I practiced corporate law for a few years. Is solving problems for people using technology, okay? So it was around the middle of 2013. I was looking, you know, for a new project to take on. And my wife, who planned our whole wedding, she said, Eddie, you should really think about talking to wedding and event professionals, specifically planners, because it was so challenging doing all the planning for our wedding. Well, it turns out my wife was dead right, as usual. I always like to say, don't tell her that I said that. But what I did after she made her suggestion, I went out and I interviewed over 200 of the top wedding planners in the country. And I asked everybody a really simple question. I said, what is the most tedious part of your job? And I heard the same answer over and over. They'd say, you know, Eddie, I love doing, you know, weddings. I love getting a couple down the aisle, but I got to tell you, timelines are really tedious and they're really time consuming. Now, after hearing this so much, I really just became obsessed. I mean, I was diagramming everybody's timeline workflow, and I was, you know, studying just dozens and dozens of timelines. And over the last 6.5 years, this is really all I've done. You know, I've just been focused on how can people create A-plus timelines in radically less time. And my research journey has carried me. I've connected with, you know, celebrity planners like Kristen Banta, Donnie Brown, Sasha Souza, other industry influencers like Sean Lowe, Tammy Ferrero, Debbie Orwat, so many amazing people. And after doing all of these years of research and connecting with all of these extraordinary individuals, I've developed a software called Timeline Genius that I think is going to blow your mind. And I'm so happy if you're with us. I just want to apologize again for the tech issues. And I promise right now is when you're going to see that it was 100% worth sticking it out. So in here. You know, I've talked to people and heard the horror stories. Oh, my laptop. To the information. So if the phone rings while you're out in the field, somebody in your office can go right in. Rolodex is where you're going to save your vendor, venue, and client information. Okay, I'm going to go kind of quickly here. And so with your client, and you all. Criteria, so you can search based on phone number or email address. They're in the palm of your hand once they're in your Rolodex. It's all there saved for you. Now for your venues, pretty similar to the way that the clients work. You've got a venue name, a contact person, a mailing address, multiple phone numbers, email address. You can even save social media information in case you want to give shout outs on the wedding day. And you've got a website, you've got your notes. You've got your venue guidelines, okay? Now, why is the venue guidelines section in here? Because if you actually, you know, I've talked to so many experienced planners and they'll say, Eddie, even if I've done 10 timelines at a given venue, I'm still looking back through the contract to try to remember what the load-in time constraints are, where the service elevator is, or whatever. So what you can do is just save those guidelines here and they'll automatically be added to your timelines, as you're going to see in just a minute. And again, you can see all of the timelines that you've worked on right here in case you want to refer to them. Same thing for your vendors, because let's say you might be wanting to make a referral. You might want to refer this photographer to a new couple. Well, you've got all the timelines or past events you've done. So you can say, let me check and see which events I did with this person to make sure that they did a good job. So the other fields here with your vendors, you've got vendor name, contact person, multiple phone numbers. You can assign this vendor a role, like are they a caterer, cake baker, etc. And you have your email address field and your social media fields and your notes field. Now, one big theme on Timeline Genius is everything is customizable. So your vendor roles, for example, if you click edit vendor roles, you get to specify which roles are going to be in your Rolodex. You know, you get to, some people want to say DJ, DJ. Some people might want to spell it out, DEEJAY. You get to pick what the vendor roles are going to look like. Now, there's another really important point I should mention. Everything that I'm showing you right now is mobile friendly. It doesn't matter if you have an iPhone, an Android phone, if you've got a tablet, whatever. All the full functionality that I'm getting ready to show you is available on any kind of mobile device. Now, I just clicked on my timeline section, okay? This is where the action really happens and where things are going to start to get exciting. I've got active and archive timelines. My archive is where my timelines go after the event is over. You see, I got some high-profile clientele here, Beyonce and Jay-Z. My active timelines are where my timelines go when they're in progress or coming up in the future. Now, when I want to create a new timeline, I click Create New Timeline. And I have the ability to use a previous timeline, to use a template, or to use the Genius feature. Now, I'm going to tell you here, the issue with timelines, the reason why wedding day timelines are challenging and time-consuming to create is because every wedding is different. No two weddings are ever identical. And here's the problem. A lot of people, you may be listening to this right now, a lot of people actually start their timelines using a template, but you're never going to have a single template that's perfect for all the different weddings, right? Because every wedding is unique. So Timeline Genius gives you three powerful ways to start your timelines. The first option you have is you can use a previous timeline. Let's say, for example, you're like, you know what, 6 months ago, I did a wedding just like this, had the same ceremony time, the same religious tradition, you know, the same, you know, photographer was booked for the same amount of time. Well, what you can do is choose this option to use a previous timeline. You select that old timeline as your starting point. You put in the new bride, groom, vendors, and venues for your new wedding. The system is going to duplicate that old timeline and automatically swap out all the names and dates for you. So you get an instantly repurposed version of that previous timeline for your new event. Now, your second option in terms of how you can start your timeline, you can use one of our preset templates, okay? So we worked with Bernadette Smith, for example, the founder of the Gay Wedding Institute, to create same-sex wedding templates. You may actually, you know, I'm not going to focus on this because I'm going to focus more on weddings in this particular presentation, but you may be doing a bar bat mitzvah. You may be doing a baby shower, a corporate event, a nonprofit event. The point is, any kind of timeline that you need to do for any kind of event, you can do on Timeline Genius. But here's one thing I really wanted to show you guys. So click Create New Timeline. The third way you can start your timeline, you can use our Genius feature. Now, this is where we really took a quantum leap forward in the way that timelines are being created. Remember, the issue with timelines is every wedding is unique. Every event is unique. We figured the best way to radically streamline this process would be to let you actually put in the key information for each event. So I'm putting in my, you know, bride and my groom. I'm going to put in my ceremony date here. I'm going to pick a religious tradition of non-denominational. I'm going to put in my ceremony time. It's 5:30 p.m. I'm going to say my ceremony is 30 minutes long. And the reception flow, you may have a couple that's like, we're nervous. We want to get our first dance over with. Or maybe they're doing cake cutting, then toasting, then first dance. Whatever the applicable order is, you get to pick it. Is there a first look? Yes or no? That has it. All of these are what we call driver variables, and they have a huge effect on the flow and structure of your timeline. Now, one little quick aside, you don't actually have to put this information in. If you want to, you can click client input. You can send an invitation to your client and let them answer these basic questions to save you time. You'll get an email notification when they submit their information. You can just click review, you know, accept and approve as you see fit and just zip through. But for now, to save time, I'm just going to kind of go through all of the questions and answers, okay? So I get to the next page and it's saying, well, what are the venues? Well, this is why we have a Rolodex, right? You can easily just put in these venues. If there's somebody that's not in your Rolodex, then you just put them in here and you click add, blah, 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 and they will go to your Rolodex, okay? River City Falls Hotel, the first look venue is Memorial Hall. Now watch this. Sometimes the ceremony and reception venues are the same, and sometimes they're different. If I put in a different reception venue, Timeline Genius now is smart enough to know, well, the ceremony and reception venues are different, so what's the travel time? So I put in 30 minutes as my travel time. Now, these inputs are all optional, but I'm going to go ahead. I'm putting in my vendors now, right? Who's doing my ceremony music? Who's doing my cocktail music? Who's doing my floral work here? So again, it's optional, but if you know it, it's going to save you a ton of time to just put this information in. Now, this is a great field. When I put in my photographer, Timeline Genius is going to say, how many hours do you have the photographer booked for? Because there's all the difference in the world in having a photographer for 10 hours versus 8 or 12, as we all know. Now, these are my absolute favorite inputs. When you put in your hairstylist, the system's going to say, does she have an assistant? Yes or no? And how long are you going to give the bride for hair? Because the bride is typically going to get longer, right? I'm going to give my bride 60 minutes. And besides the bride, how many other girls are getting hair services? Well, I'm going to say there are four other girls, and I'm going to give them 30-minute slots, and I'm going to say their names are Wendy, Pam, Sue, and Mary, okay? And now I'm going to put in my makeup stylist, and it's going to give me the same questions because hair and makeup go together. Does the makeup stylist have an assistant? No. Does my how long am I giving my bride? I'm giving her an hour for makeup. How many girls besides the bride are getting hair services? I'll say four. And for the sake of simplicity, I'm just going to say it's Wendy, Pam, Sue, and Mary who are also getting hair and makeup. Now, I'm just going to kind of move on here in the interest of efficiency. And I just kind of look this over. Okay, if this information is all correct, I click Generate Timeline. And now the magic happens. A very powerful algorithm is going to work. It's taking all of this key information that I entered for this wedding, and it's using it to construct, magically construct, an initial timeline that's tailor-made for this event. Now, I want to mention a very important point. This timeline is totally editable. I'm going to show you how you can edit this timeline, and it's so much easier to edit than it would be as a Google Doc or a Word doc. But what I want to show you before I show you how to edit it, right off the bat, look, hair and makeup is done. Like, it put my bride in, it gave her an hour, it, you know, put everybody else in and gave them 30-minute slots. So if Mary starts hair at 10, she goes right into makeup at 10:30. Nobody's double booked. If you've ever had to plan a hair and makeup table, I think you'll appreciate just how nice it is to have it instantly done. Not just done, but optimized, right? Not only that, all of these items now, the times are calculated. You've got a first look photo session. Well, okay, it builds that in because that changes the whole flow of the day. And really, what the algorithm's genius feature is actually doing, if you were doing this timeline by hand, you would start with your ceremony at 5:30 p.m., right? Because that's what we said. It's a 5:30 ceremony. You'd work your way back to the prelude, and you'd work your way back all the way to the beginning of the day, right? And then what would you do? You'd come to your ceremony and say, okay, if the ceremony is 30 minutes long, it's going to stop at 6 p.m., and we know that their ceremony and reception venues are separate because that's what the system told us here when we put them in. So 10 minutes after my ceremony's over, my wedding party has to leave to go to their cocktail hour, and it even built in the travel time, which I said is 30 minutes, so they're going to arrive at 6:40, right? And not only that, I said in the reception, I said cake cutting is going to happen before toasting, which will happen before the first dance. Well, look at this. Cake cutting, toasting, first dance, salads, entrees, and all of that stuff are there, right? It even bakes in my photographer. It's like, okay, we said he's booked for 10 hours. So if he's there, we've got him for 10 hours, he's going to leave at 10, and he's going to show up at 12, and we know that he's going to the high because the system actually knows where he should be at all points in time. So underneath the timeline items, you're going to see this section for items to remember. If I had said that this is a Jewish wedding, it would have said, well, don't forget the pen to sign the ketubah. Don't forget the kiddush cup and the glass to step on to say mazel tov. It's just like having a genius on your shoulder to make sure you're not dropping any balls, right? Now, if you want to edit this, you click on this and say, I want to get rid of the garter toss. I don't like garter tosses, and I want to make this bold. Well, you can do whatever you want because this is all totally editable. If you want to change this little header here and just call it notes and reminders instead of items to remember, you can change it. Your venue guidelines. So remember in the Rolodex where I showed you guys that you can add your venue guidelines? Well, this is where your venue guidelines are now automatically inserted because you told us where the ceremony and reception venues are. So we automatically add the guidelines here for you. Now, your venue and vendor contact information, I got to pause and just talk about these because I can't tell you how many planners I've talked to who say, you know, yeah, I got to have all my vendor info in there. What if my limo driver gets lost and I got to call them on the spot? Or what if I need to touch base with my florist? You've got to have your contact info in your timeline, and we don't want you rummaging around. You know, you say, oh, I got to find the latest phone number for my photographer. Let me go to my email inbox and see if I have it there, or go to the photographer's website. But then you're looking at cat videos on Facebook, and 20 minutes later, you're still looking at cat videos and you're sidetracked, right? So lay off the cat videos, let Timeline Genius just like automatically add your vendor contacts here. And if you want to drag and drop items in your vendor contact section into a different order, you can do it. Again, your social media info even is here so you can give shout outs. Now your wedding party contacts, this is where you're going to add your bridesmaids, your groomsmen, flower girl, all that stuff if you want to. And you also have a files section. You want to upload your floor plan, your contracts, images that you can share with people. It's almost like having like a personal Dropbox folder just for this event. But the main point, I'm going to scroll up here to the top. The main point here is what I said. All of these items are editable. So if I click on this item, I can edit it. You want to add bullet points? No problem. You come here, you add bullet points. You want to change this to like red font color to call it out for a particular vendor. You want to highlight something to remind yourself to come back and change it later or change something to be bold. You can do that. Obviously, you may also need to change times. If I click on this time, first of all, I can set it to be TBD Maybe I don't know what time this is supposed to be, so I want to set it to TBD. Or maybe I just want to move this to like 3:17 p.m. or some weird time like that. If you enter a new time, the system is always going to keep your timeline items in chronological order, so you don't have to think about that anymore, right? Or I come here and I take this 5 p.m. item, I drag it, I drop it up to the 4:30 slot, and presto, it's going to automatically update to be 4:30. Now, the really cool thing is, if you guys have done enough weddings, this has probably happened. The bride calls you. She says, you know, I want to move this item by 15 minutes. Has no idea that if you change that item by 15 minutes, you're going to also have to change this and this and this. Now, I'm going to hold my shift key down, okay? And I'm going to check this box, and it's going to check in all the boxes in between. The idea here is it's very easy for me to whip through this timeline to check the boxes for a lot of timeline items. So I've checked the box for 50 timeline items. I click bulk edit, time shift, okay? And I can take these items forward or backwards using my plus or minus. I'm going to take everything forward by 15 minutes. I click apply, and in a matter of just 2 or 3 seconds, Timeline Genius is going to shift 50 items 15 minutes ahead. Now, you can imagine how long that would take if you're like working in Word or Excel or something like that on your timeline. Now, the other really cool thing is, if I want to, I can click on my – I have all of my clients, vendors, and venues here, right? If I click on my cake baker, I instantly see a version of the timeline, a nice PDF timeline with my logo on it. You know, it looks professional. And this is just for my cake baker, right? And it's got the timeline items that are relevant to the cake baker. Why? Because maybe this is a nice professional touch for you. You don't want to have your cake baker digging through a 10-page timeline to find 4 items that apply to her. So you give her, as a nice professional touch, this timeline. It reduces the likelihood she's going to forget about something and just makes her life easier, which is good, right? Now, how does that work? Well, the reason you can do that, and the same thing I should mention for your wedding party, if you click on your bride here, you instantly get a wedding party version of the timeline because you don't necessarily need to give the full timeline to the wedding party. Now, how does that work? Well, if you click this V, every item is expandable, and you can see I've got venues and vendors that have been assigned to every item. So right now, for example, my florist has been assigned to this because the Genius feature made intelligent assumptions about which vendors and venues should be assigned to what. So right now, this item will appear on the tailored timeline for my florist. But if I don't want that to happen, I click delete, and now that item is no longer, my florist is no longer assigned to that item, so that item will not appear on my florist tailored timeline. And maybe I want to add a new vendor here. So I click add a vendor, and I'm going to add my rental company, Bespoke Rentals. Now, Bespoke Rentals is automatically going to get added to my right side panel. Bespoke Rentals will also automatically be added here to my vendor contact section. You don't have to think about it. And now this item that I assigned my rental company to, this item will appear on the tailored timeline for my rental company. Now, you may be saying, well, Eddie, what if I want to assign my rental company to like 20 different items? Are you telling me, Eddie, I gotta go one at a time, clicking expand and clicking add vendor, clicking expand, add vendor? Of course not. We wouldn't be doing our jobs if it was that inefficient. All you gotta do is click this assign tab. You see, every timeline has an edit tab, an assign tab, a collaborate tab, and a remind tab. When you go to your assign tab, you see your wedding party, your venues and vendors. You see a nice color-coded display that shows you who's been assigned to what. You want to assign your rental company to a bunch of items? Check the box for your rental company. Check the boxes. Again, I'm going to use my little shift key trick. Check these boxes. So when I click assign selections, my rental company or the selected vendor is going to be assigned to the selected item, in this case 5 items, and now those 5 timeline items will appear on the tailored timeline for my vendor. Now, obviously, you can add additional timeline items. You may even want to add a new day of timeline items. It's totally customizable. Just click add timeline item, and I'm going to put this on October 22nd. This is new. I would set the time. When you click save, it's going to put that new item on whatever day you specified at whatever time. Again, you don't have to think about chronological order here. The system handles that for you. I'm going to delete this item and show you one more really cool feature inside the editing sort of bucket. So you can actually insert images. So let's say I come here and reception room fully prepared. Well, I actually want to show what the tablescape is going to look like. So I click this image icon, I click choose file, and now I'm actually, I mean, this is just something that I randomly pulled off of Google, but I'm going to show exactly what my tablescape images should look like. So I come here and I click save, and there's my tablescape image, or better yet, again, customize, customize, customize. You see this this notes and reminders section and venue guidelines. These are just text sections. You can add a whole new text section. You just click add text section. And I'm going to make this my floor plan because I think it's a good touch to put your floor plan into your timeline. So I'm going to come here and I'm actually going to click my image icon. I'm going to grab my floor plan. And this is just, again, a generic floor plan I got off of a Google image search. And now my floor plan is actually added inside my timeline. Maybe you want to reorder the sections. All you got to do is click timeline actions, reorder sections. Some people like their vendor info at the top of the timeline. You can just drag and drop these sections into whatever order you want. You can customize your header here if you want to, like, put the sunset time for an outdoor wedding, or, you know, whatever you want to do, right? Like, it's totally customizable. That's the whole point here, okay? Now, I want to show you a couple other things that are really exciting. And I know we lost a little bit of time up front here, so I'm going to go kind of quickly. Timelines are not about you working by yourself. Timelines are about you collaborating efficiently. So like I said, every timeline here is going to have an edit, assign, collaborate, and remind tab. Go to your collaborate tab. See, what we don't want is for you to be sending out emails, like 14 different emails with Word documents and Excel files attached, and you're getting feedback from all these different places. No. What we want to do is take advantage of the cloud, take advantage of the internet. So you go to your collaborate tab, you see your clients, vendors, and venues here. You click this gear icon, and you can invite any of these people to access the timeline online. And if you want to, you can even copy the invitation link and send your own personal email to the person. But if you send the invitation through our system, here's what it's going to go out looking like, okay? Now, this is about you. It's not about Timeline Genius. So your company name is in this email, in the subject. It's your logo in the email, okay? Now, in this case, John is my sample client. It says, hey, John, here's an invitation to access your timeline online. Whenever you want to go to your timeline, just click the button below. John clicks this button to go to his timeline. And we're going to give him a little notification to tell him how, you know, the collaboration works. So he sees this. He's like, okay, I got it. Now he's looking at his timeline. It's got your logo on it because, again, this is an extension of your branding. And notice John did not have to create an account. Ain't nobody got time for that, right? Nobody's got time to create yet another account on the internet. So John can see this timeline, but you have complete control over what John sees. What do I mean? When you're in your collaborate view, you select John. Now you're in your collaborate mode with John specifically, okay? Every single item, you have the option. It's not like Google Docs. Google Docs, you collaborate, it's like all or nothing. Either they get access and can see the document or they can't. Here, you have control item by item. Do I want this item to be viewable by my client, hidden from my client, or editable by my client? And the same access settings are available for every single vendor and venue, every potential collaborator. Now, the default is it's viewable by that collaborator. So, you know, John, it's viewable. That means he can see it, but he can't make changes because, honestly, he might do more harm than good, right? Like, he doesn't necessarily know how your timeline works. Now, if he wants to, even though it's view only, he can come here and say, is this final? Or he can post a question, he can post a comment, whatever. When he does that, if you refresh your page, you're going to see a notification here telling you that John actually just posted a comment, right? You're going to see that there. You're going to see the dot here to let you know, and you're going to be able to expand this. And now you and John can go back and forth, okay? And nobody else can see what comments you're making. Or if you select the Hyatt Regency, you can go back and forth with the Hyatt, and nobody else can see what you're saying. Now, your other options, as I mentioned, you can also hide an item from John. Why? Maybe there's a surprise that you don't want him to know about, like this item. Maybe his bride is going to serenade him. Well, if it's hidden, you can see it's just completely invisible to John. Your last option, you may want to make items editable. Wedding party contact section is a great example. Why not just let John have edit rights to that? So if Brad's not a groomsman anymore, you've already got more emails probably than you know what to do with. He doesn't need to email you about that. Let John just go right in. Make the update directly, you're going to get notified, and everything is going to be silky smooth. And if you upload files, this is where you can pick which collaborators have access to those files. And you can even allow John, if you want, to have download rights to the timeline so he doesn't have to bother you, you know? And this is for millennial clients, for people now that expect real-time, mobile-friendly access. John can whip out his phone, see his timelines, and post comments for you, and you and John are going back and forth, and everything is clean and professional. Now, this is really exciting to me. I just clicked on the Reminder tab. Again, every timeline has Edit, Assign, Collaborate, and Remind. In your Reminder view, you and your teammates are here, your clients are here, your wedding party or event guests are here, your venues and vendors are listed. You can set reminders for anybody. I'll start with a simple case. Maybe you want to set a text reminder for yourself. You check me and you say, I want this reminder to go out 25 minutes before this item, and this item, okay? You click Set Reminders. Timeline Genius now has set reminders that will go out on the event day 25 minutes before those items. Think about the use cases. You know, you want your ladies in your wedding party to get a text 20 minutes before hair and makeup, zzz, hair and makeup in room 209. You know, you want your florist to get a text before the drop-offs of the flowers, no problem. You just set these reminders and then they're gonna go out. You're gonna look like a ninja on the wedding day. They're gonna be like, I thought she's over there. How am I getting text reminders, right? So when it's all said and done, I wanna show you what the timeline looks like. I'm sure you're interested in seeing that. So you come here, when it's all said and done, this is just a sample timeline. I click Timeline Actions, Download, Full Timeline. I can download my wedding party timeline, timelines for my vendors, my venues, in PDF or Word format. I click Download, and now what you're gonna get is a zip file, okay? And this zip file is gonna contain all the different versions of the timeline that you selected. Okay, so I'm gonna unzip this file. And now if you look, for example, at your full timeline, this will just kind of give you a general sense of what it looks like. You know, if you customize your header, that info's there. You know, you've got your logo there. Your hair and makeup tables look really professional. You know, your first look photo's there. I didn't even mention this, but you can actually set hyperlinks in your timelines. This is a great function. You want to link to a playlist or something for music? Have at it. Just put the hyperlink in. You come down, you've got images in your timeline if you insert them. You've got your list of items to remember, and you've got your venue guidelines, you've got your venue contacts, vendor contacts, you know, your wedding party contacts. It's all here. It looks great. It looks professional. You know, and you can customize the look of this timeline. So let me just show you this briefly. If I preview this timeline PDF, you know, we've got preferences built in here. So if you go to preferences, you may say, you know, I want grid lines on my times and I want to show repeat times. Well, if you set those preferences and then refresh and look at this PDF, you're going to have grid lines and you're going to see timelines now for all the repeat items if that's what you want. You know, two items happening at 12, it's going to say 12 p.m., 12 p.m. You may also decide, you know, from the assigned view, I want to show Eddie the venues and vendors that are assigned to every item. You click update. When I come back here and refresh, now I'm actually even going to see all the vendors and venues that are involved. I've got little tags. Totally customizable to your workflow. You want to work with team members? Click on your company name and click account members. All you got to do is invite people to access your company account. Everybody can have a separate login for Timeline Genius. Everybody can get in here and use it. And when you have multiple team members, you can choose to follow or not follow timelines to determine whether or not you want to get reminders. You know, if you got a bunch of people working on your timelines, you may not want to get reminders for every single timeline. So you can unfollow those timelines if you want to. So there's more that I could obviously walk you guys through, but what I want to do here, because I know we're bumping up on our time, and I'll hang out here and take questions if anybody has questions, but what I really wanted to show you guys is I set up a really special offer for you here today. If you go to timelinegenius.com/event-pro-special-offer, I will I'll post this link for you guys actually here in the thread. Let me do this for you. I think I've got it right here, actually. Yeah, actually, this is it right here. So I'll just post this in the thread for you guys right here. Boom. Yeah, so if you do that, you can actually get a very special offer. And this special offer, hopefully you guys are still seeing my screen. But this special offer is going to let you get unlimited timelines for $299 annually. Again, the link here is timelinegenius.com/event-pro-special-offer. And let me tell you why this offer is so amazing, okay? The first reason is because you're getting a $96 discount basically off of what is otherwise a $395 subscription. That's how much Timeline Genius costs. If you go to our website, timelinegenius.com, and you look at our pricing, you're going to see that it costs $395 a year. So right off the bat, you're saving almost $100 because you're signing up for $299. But the really important thing here that I want you to know is that if you get this special offer today, you're going to be able to lock in this rate for the lifetime of your company. Okay, that means as long as you renew each year, no matter how many new features we add, no matter how many users you have, whatever, you're always going to have this special price of $299. Okay. We're going to import your vendors for you, and I'm going to throw in a celebrity planner timeline template as a bonus. We got different celebrities from around the world to actually share their timeline, which is not something that planners often do. But the very important thing, I want you to know that this offer is going to end. If you look here at the page, if you're seeing the page, you can see it's going to expire at midnight Pacific time. So I know some of you are on the West Coast. So it expires today. It'll be 3 a.m. Eastern time, basically 6 hours from now. But yeah, it's at timelinegenius.com/event-pro-special-offer. And I'm here to take questions. If you guys have any, please feel free to chime in. And I could tell you the reason why I think this is such a special deal is because there are some amazing new features coming. We're really getting into the execution of timelines, not just the creation of the wedding day timeline, which is primarily what I was focused on here. We're really going to be getting into the execution. So you can say, okay, the shuttles are 20 minutes late on the wedding day, right? And or event day, whatever it is, and you say, I'm going to whip out my phone and I'm going to shift the whole timeline back by 20 minutes, and I want to send out a push notification to all the vendors. Everybody gets a text, you know, a push notification that says, hey, the timeline shifted by 20 minutes. Well, 10 of the vendors text back. They reply one that they got it, and three of them say, you know, you don't hear back. So you know I need to go tap these three vendors on the shoulder and tell them, hey, the shuttles are 20 minutes late. So it's really like we're going to be getting into that. We're going to be adding more features to the Genius feature, more questions so that you can actually you know, it's just going to account for more and more. Like it's going to say, do you have 0, 1, or 2 limos for the wedding party? Okay, you got one limo. That means we take the girls and go back and get the guys. What's the capacity for your shuttle buses for the guest transportation? My vision for this, and I know this sounds really bold, but it's definitely something that I see very clearly. My vision is that this work process that used to be a 10 or 15 hour job of tedious labor, creating really detailed timelines, that work process is going to be shrunk down to like a 20-minute task. And you're going to be able to create your own questionnaires. That's coming this year in 2020. So again, I encourage anybody that has questions, you guys can post here. If you want to email me, you can catch me at eddie@timelinegenius. That's eddie@timelinegenius.com. And so I'm here. If you guys need anything, my job and my passion is really to elevate this industry and to do all I can for you guys to help you out. We also have a podcast that I think you'll really like. It's called the Wedding Industry Insider Podcast. I've interviewed people ranging from David Tutera to, you know, Kristen Banta, Angela Proffitt, just the really amazing, positive, forward-thinking people in our industry. So get on board, take advantage of the offer. And then the one last thing that I'll leave you guys with, unless anybody has questions, again, I'm happy to hang out for a few minutes and talk and answer questions. But the last thing that I'll leave you all with, if you go to timelinegenius.com and just sign up for a free trial, sign up for free trial with and enter, I'm going to say put in 777 as the number of events per year, we will flag your account out for special treatment. So if you take advantage of this offer, you can disregard what I'm saying here, but even if you don't take advantage of the offer that I'm presenting here tonight, if you just go to timelinegenius.com and sign up for a free trial, and you know, you're going to put in your first name, your name, your company name, your email address, and then it's going to ask you how many events per year do you do. If you put in 777, then I'll know that you came from the Event Professionals Marketplace Facebook group. And I've spoken to Lorna already about giving you all some special treatment. So if you do nothing else besides just going to timelinegenius.com and creating your account and putting 77 in as your events per year, do that so we can give you some really special treatment. So it's really been a pleasure talking to you all. I'm so sorry about the tech issues. I'm traveling tonight and spoke at another conference. So hopefully you guys were able to stick around and see Timeline Genius, because if you're doing timelines, it's going to save you a ton of time. So thank you all. God bless. And yeah, I hope to work with you.